and welcome back to Gal. Here I'm in Las Vegas at the NAB show, and Adobe has released a bunch of cool updates. Last week I showed you guys a new content aware fill inside of After Effects, and today I'm going to be taking a close look at the new essential graphics updates inside of Premiere Pro. So if you guys haven't watched that other video, I definitely encourage you guys to watch it. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into Premiere Pro. All right, everyone, we are inside of the latest version of Premiere Pro, and everything I'm about to show you is only available in the latest version. So make sure if you go up to Premiere Pro, about Premiere Pro, that you're seeing version 13.1 or above. And if you do not have that, just be sure to go up to your little Creative Cloud, go to your apps, and make sure that you're updated. All right, so the first tip I wanted to show you in the new essential graphics panel update is masking text so you can place images and video inside of it. So to do that, first, let's go ahead and make some new text using the type tool. So I'll just type out gal here, and I'll go ahead and just increase the size of it as well as the scale here. And then using the align and transform tools, I'm just going to center it in screen. Now what we're going to do is add our video layer inside of the essential graphics panel. So I'm going to click on new layer and then from file. And this is where I'm going to choose a video shot. So let's say we wanted to use this beach aerial shot, import that. And then you'll notice that it's a lower resolution than my sequence. That's no problem. All I'm going to do is just scale it up like so. Then I'm going to drag this video underneath the text layer. Now I want the video to be inside of the text. So what I'm going to do is select the type tool, then down here under appearance, select mask with text, and then bam, the video is inside of the text. So then this is where we can decide where we want the video to be within the text. So you can select this video shot and then move it around until it's in the right position that you want. So then when we play it back, you can see the video is playing inside of the text. Now, if you wanted to, you can also put a mat behind this text. So what I like to do is go down here to new item and select color mat, hit okay, and then I'm just gonna choose a color. And then I'm going to drag and drop that underneath. So now it's a white background. And if you select the text, we can add a shadow. So I'm going to increase the transparency up so it's not quite transparent. And then add some distance. And I'm going to darken this up a bit. Now, the next tip I wanted to show you with this update is the new background. So what I'm going to do is just click on the timeline to create a new graphics layer. And let's make a lower third here. So let's decrease the size. And then let's type out just Premiere Gal, like so. Let's say we wanted to make a simple lower third. Let's just decrease the size a little bit. I'm also going to turn on the safe margins for title safe, just to make sure everything is inside of this inner line. So that way, if you're working in TV or broadcast, you know that it won't get cut off. So let's say we wanted to put a rectangle behind this. Before this update, we would actually have to go in and create a rectangle using the rectangle tool. But now what we can do is actually just select this type layer and go down and select background. And it automatically creates a background for you that fits perfectly. And you can decrease the size or increase it to be as close to the text as you like. So I think around here looks pretty cool. Just going to change the color to be a little bit lighter blue, like so. And if you want the shadow on the text, you can. I kind of like the shadow. I'm just going to reduce the distance just a little bit, like so. So here we have just a basic lower third title, and we don't have to worry about pinning the frame to create responsive design. Because if I was going to change this text, so if I select this text and I was going to type something else like lower third, you can see that it automatically adapts to the text size, and we don't have to worry about creating shapes. So the next update I wanted to show you is in the wrench tools again. We now have show rulers, which is the rulers up in the program panel, so you can easily align things with the use of guides. So if you show guides, now here, if I wanted to create a guideline for a lower third to always align it, I can just pull this over, and same up here, I can take this down. And let's say I want my text to always be aligned here. All we need to do is go down and snap, enable snap in the program monitor. And then when you select this text layer using the selection tool, if it's up here, you can just bring it down and bam, it snaps right into place. It's like a magnet. So you can save these guides as a template as well. So if you go up to view, guide templates, you can save guide as template, just like that. And now when you go up here, you can choose lower third left, or if you wanted to enable lower third right, which I have here, it'll show you that particular guide that you have saved. So this is just a quick way to easily move things around. And another tip I wanted to show you is how to make very minute, small movements inside of your program monitor with Essential Graphics. So if I go down here and you zoom into 200%, you will see what I'm talking about. So now what you can do is hold Shift and Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and use the arrow keys to move it over 5 pixels. See that? So you can do very small movements using the arrow keys, holding the Shift, Command, and arrow keys. So this just helps when you're designing your motion graphics and allows you to have more flexibility to move things in smaller movements. Before, you would have to just use the arrow key and like move it around, and you didn't get a lot of accuracy. So that's it for the Essential Graphics updates. If you guys have any questions about anything that I covered, be sure to leave a comment below. And also, I design templates myself specifically for you guys to use inside of Premiere Pro, and they're Mogurts. If you guys want to become monthly patrons at patreon.com/premieregal, you guys can get templates delivered to your inbox every month. I also sell all of the templates on my store, and I'll put a link in the description box below. Thanks so much for watching, you guys, and I'll see you guys next time.